So I just made a 12,000 rand diagnostics mistake, and I actually want to take you guys over it. This was on a Polo TSI that was having a problem, and I would like you guys not to make the same mistake that I made. That's why I'm going to be showing you what was the problem with the car and what I found. So initially this car came in for a cam belt service and an EPC light that kept coming on that the customer was complaining about. Cam belt service was done. That was very easy, didn't take us a long time, and we checked the EPC light and found this fault. So after checking the car, we found that that clip was broken, and the car also had an intake leak over there where the air cooler sits. Normally on the Polo TSI, if you see that, that will cause a boost pressure leak. So that's exactly what we thought was the problem. So we did remove this air cooler to try and reseal it and replace the sealant. So this was the air intake after resealing. It looked very nice, it looked very clean, and little did I know, I thought that the issue would be resolved. We also replaced this boost pressure pipe coupling. I thought that the issue was going to be resolved, and the customer sent us this video just hours of taking the vehicle back. It was the vehicle doing the very same thing. When it reaches 4,000 revs, it was giving out this EPC light. So resealing the intake manifold did not help, so it was back to square one. So what we then did was we replaced the intake manifold. This part of the video is just for demonstration purposes. We replaced this intake manifold because I started to think that it had a crack. I replaced it, and lo and behold, the vehicle didn't have an issue. I even got arrogant and said that after I replaced it with my intake manifold, the vehicle doesn't have an issue. So I called the customer, told him that we need to replace his intake manifold. So the intake manifold costed about 12,000 rand. That's the quotation we got from the agents. So before I bought it, I said, let me take it on another test drive. And look, this bloody EPC light came back again with my good intake manifold. So I said, all right, now it's time to get down to business. Let's go on Haynes and try and research this fault. So I hate doing this process because it takes a while and you need to be very, very patient. So we started off by putting on the CJZ, which is the engine number of this vehicle, and you have to look for the correct vehicle, so the correct kilowatts, because if you got the incorrect kilowatts, as you'll see on the video, you will see no TSBs, no smart cases, and no recall data. So as you can see on this part of the video, I put on the trouble code, and the car that I picked was also a Polo 5 or Polo 6, but it was an 88 kilowatt. And as you can see, it's got no recalls, no smart case, and no TSBs. So it was the wrong vehicle. So I then decided to go to the 66 kilowatt, which was the correct kilowatts for this Polo TSI. And I did find a TSB. Let's check it out. So after I found the 66 kilowatt Polo TSI, I punched in this trouble code that I kept getting, and now you will see the magic. So there's nothing on smart case, there's also nothing on recall data, but look at that, there is something on TSB. So now what we need to do, we need to go on this TSB, because it'll give us a hint on what might be wrong with the vehicle. So you'll start by looking at symptom first, and then now it's got our symptoms, and it tells us that the EPC warning light illuminates and the engine control unit has a fault, and that's the fault that you will get, air intake system leakage. So now it tells you the cause. The cause is a faulty engine control unit software. All right, so that's a very big indication and a very big sign, and it also gives you a solution. And the solution to this one was that it needed you to update the engine control unit software. It needed an ECU upgrade. So I did do an ECU upgrade, and this was the test drive after I did the ECU upgrade. Number of times I tested this vehicle a number of times, and the EPC is not coming on. Luckily, we did not buy that 12,000 rand intake. I just decided to take my time. So if you have the same issue, make sure you look at it this way as well, or you do an ECU upgrade and you will not have any issues. All right, sharp.